Yeah, motion to open meeting at 7:05 PM.
Second.
What do you need?
No, we didn't. All right, so what the idea tonight is to finalize our, right, finalize our agenda, or finalize, our registration packet, which, did everybody go over that by any chance?
Like, did you get a copy of it? You did, right? Okay.
Is this right? Or was there another version? I printed it.
No, that was, yeah, that was the one.
I couldn't get mine to print.
Oh, really?
Mine printed and it didn't print by page. It was like.
Mike says you are unable to edit, therefore you are unable to print.
Okay, so I think we were still looking at items in red. Kelly brought something to my attention I needed to change to, which was under payment process. So we're looking for payment for the early birds, payment in full by May 12th. But my, so the question was if they, if they're not doing the early bird, they have until June 12th.
Yes.
Okay, so if you're an early bird, you have to be paid in full by May 12th. If you're not an early bird, it's paid in full by June 12th.
May 12th?
Yeah, May 12th for early bird and June 12th for.
Does that all make, right, we just want to confirm that, but I read through the minutes. And that was my understanding of what we decided, right, as a group?
Yes.
You're a new face for me.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Shayna.
Shayna, how are you? I'm Kelly.
So how many kids in total are they allowing?
For early bird or just?
Just in general for camp.
Well, we didn't have a limit because we were anticipating having backups ready to hire more people.
Oh, okay.
So on the last.
Because I was, that was part of my thing, because I remember that we talked about way back was number.
So I think we were probably approximating between 80 and 100, and we were at least hoping between 80 and 100. Keeping a tight leash on how many are registered.
And what did we say, 1 to 16?
So we need to get more counselors.
Okay, so if we, you guys had your, do you have your copy from this? Did you guys have a chance to print that out?
I did.
That, no, you didn't.
It's okay. I actually, can I ask to be put back onto the Google Drive if possible? Because I'm going to get anything. I got a new phone since I've been out, and the Google Drive, so.
Oh.
Are you still
using
that?
Yeah.
Okay.
And this went out by email.
Yeah.
So you haven't been receiving our emails.
Well, the emails are coming through very jumbled, so I'm not getting, like, I'll go and get the attachment or whatever's available on the attachment, and I'm getting only messages or messages from return messages or replies.
Okay.
So I'm not getting.
So you need the original with the attachment?
Yes. Yes.
Hmm.
I find that with my iPhone, it drives me crazy.
Okay.
All right, I'm sending the updated version to you right now. Let's see if it gets there.
Have your phone on.
I did.
That's me, hold.
See what happens?
And you would be
Lester.
White guy in the corner. We'll see if it comes jumbled for you and not for me.
Yes.
It's actually the first one, the final last. The document shows up.
Will be.
I've been getting all the replies and the documents.
How come you don't have it?
I think it's the same. My margins are different.
Yeah, they are.
You go to print it and you tell them to ignore the margins. Okay, so then. All right, so we've got it clear, the early bird registration being painful, so we know that.
All right, I just got it.
Because we had a whole discussion at the last meeting about how are we going to ensure that you're not going to pay the $35
and
right,
hold your price.
And I did, I read through the, your minutes, which I don't know if we want to go back and approve them, but that's part of our agenda. And we did vote on that, that the early bird money was if you paid in full, you could still register early, right, to hold your spot,
mm-hmm.
but you had to pay for the early price by May 12th, your money had to be in.
Yeah.
And I believe that's what we all,
yeah, okay.
we were all good with.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes. So they can drop it off here.
Well, that's part of, that's on page two, we're trying
yeah,
to figure out what.
Well, we will put a line through camp hours.
Because
we'll
my big thing was, why can't we just pay online? And I was like, future state.
Yeah, yeah, we can't do that yet.
Not yet.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, so if there, so if you, that was really my only question was a part about the payment. So I think this, if everybody can see, it's kind of on the older one too, Lester, if you have that.
I got the newer one, I'm looking at
it. Okay,
right now.
So just, so what I'm looking at is that first box that Dee's wording is if
yeah.
registered before May 12th. That needs to read if payment is received in full by, or paid in full by May 12th to receive that.
Yeah.
That was really my only question on that first page. So if anybody else had anything to chip in.
Nothing on the first page?
No. No?
Okay.
So good.
So page two, so one of the things that were in question was, one of the first items that were still in question was the registration date. So we are, I know we're aiming for at least March 1st. So I think maybe we go back to this after, so if we can get through all this,
right.
then that's
mm-hmm.
a good sign.
Yeah.
It will be March 1st. So my question on how to register was, can we leave a packet of registration forms here at the town hall?
Yeah.
We can do that.
You're on how to register?
Yep. Page two, how to register.
Yep.
So who do I talk to about that? Just asking them where I can help
you. Just email to me, and I'm here every Monday, so if you finish it tonight and get it to me tomorrow, I'll put them off and leave them at town hall.
Okay.
Or you can email Kate or Caroline, and they'll just print them off and leave them here as well.
Okay.
So whenever it's ready.
Dan, did you do you know where we at?
I read the one online. And
okay.
She said at home, I don't have a copy of
okay.
it.
Okay.
I don't obviously have a device.
Big thing, yes.
I need some.
Now,
so
I.
Do you want to go make copies?
Do you want to go then?
Email, who did you say? Email
with
registration forms?
Kate or Caroline.
Email.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, I think that's all.
I'm Dan.
Hi, Dan. Caroline.
We're not that rich of a town.
So if we leave the registration forms here, we can assume that they can return them here as well, right?
That's okay. So do we have like a mailbox where we just take it?
So if they label the envelope, they'll take it and then you put it on Joey's desk.
Okay.
And then I can collect them. So we can assume that.
Or you can do a tension rec committee. That's what I did for my posting. For the jobs, like attention rec committee, and send it to the town hall. And they know Jody is our ex officiato, and she'll get them all on her desk.
Okay, so.
But you were going to collect registration forms, right?
I thought so. Remember we talked about it? I said, no, I don't want it.
No, don't remember. But I'll be good with that.
I didn't want to
inundate. One last thing on your plate.
I didn't want
to
inundate.
Well, I grabbed, so this is the registration packet from last year.
I actually had the first two pages in my house that went with that.
There were two pages?
Yep. Oh. It talked about t-shirts, it talked about your field trips.
See, I didn't even know.
I'll take them
there. Look at that. Look at, I didn't even finish with my emergency contact phone number on that. Isn't that horrible? This is my page. Oh.
All right, so we can do that.
So packets are being returned to town hall, or are they being returned to you?
So there's, how did we have this?
Yeah, how did we do
how to register.
Naked now, Jody.
So completed
Completed registration packets can be, with your $35 registration fee, can be mailed directly here to the town hall, labeled. It will go to Jody. Jody's already asked them about that, so that can happen. They can drop them off at the Rollinsford Grade School. They can drop them up here at the town hall. Or they can go to any of the events that we have listed above, which is something we need to work on. So we know March 18th, the town meeting, and we knew that we're gonna piggyback on our GS event. We just don't know which one yet.
And did we find out anything more? I see the header doesn't have a contact number. Did we find out if we can get an extension here?
Jody said no, because that's costing money, or that will cost money. So we're not gonna do that. The way they're gonna contact us is by email. As soon as we have a director, we've hired a director, we're gonna start putting the phone number on some of this paperwork.
Ooh, their phone number.
Yeah, their phone number, yeah. They can answer calls and flag questions. Or they can go right to the Recreation Committee website or email and ask us any questions that they want until then. Yeah, this is the email address right here that we use.
Because I thought, you know, we had discussed it the last time that questions were going to go to Kelly until we got a director. So they're not going to go to Kelly?
No, they're going to go right to the mailbox.
Okay.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thanks.
Well, that, so that email address
yeah.
goes direct to the email address that we used today.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's
okay.
That's our email.
Perfect.
Address, yeah.
So all of us will get it.
Yeah, so it's just a matter of who's going to flag the questions. If you want to flag the questions from there.
That's fine, I'll do it.
Yes.
Okay.
Put me in that lead. I'll do that. Answering the email that comes to us. Would you, who's got my copy?
Oh. And then, I know we're still, are we still looking on the how to register part? Roxanne brought up having a table at the penny sale, the Rollinsford penny sale. That is the big fundraiser for the PTO, typically, and that's in March.
We actually are looking to move the date of that because we've had a huge change in officers.
PTO, you're part of the PTO too?
Yes,
yeah.
I'm actually elected VP at the moment.
Okay.
So I can get back to you as far
yeah.
as what's going to happen with the date.
So that's not going to happen in March, would you say?
Chances are no, because we don't believe we're going to have enough time to get everything together.
Okay.
So
okay.
We're aiming
it's good
for
to
April
know.
23rd.
Okay.
Yeah,
which would actually be better for us to have everything more coordinated by then.
Well, we hope to have this out anyway, so that would just be another avenue for
so
us.
So why don't we do this for now under events? Why don't I just leave the March 18th town meeting because we know we're going to be there.
Yes.
So why don't we just leave that for now? I'll cross off the piggyback.
Yeah.
And if we need to, when we figure out what event we're going to piggyback on, we can put it on Facebook and do a blast that way.
Sounds good.
Think?
Okay.
Yep.
And we could probably do an email blast through Tia saying it's ready. And people could go to the site and look at
it. So how to register is going to be, your information packets can be found on the town website under the Rec Committee tab. So Jody said we can post all the registration paperwork there, so they can go there to get it. They can get it from the Rollinsford Grade School, which was a question I had. Do we want to give the kids registration packets like we did the flyer, or do we just want to make sure they're available there at the school if the parents want them?
So you said, let me go back a second. You said they're going online through the Rec tab, or no?
Yeah, they go to the town of Rollinsford, and they go onto our tab. I think it's boards or committees.
Yes. Right now there is nothing on there that has had a contact us or anything. I was just there. It just says about the ice rink, has a blurb about that, and then another small blurb about some family fun day.
Jody, who takes care of the website?
Tia. Whenever you send it to you, she'll put it up there.
So it's Tia that can add
mm-hmm.
Summer Rec.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So we can have a PDF of this on them? So then I'd say just have the flyer and just say.
You don't want to send something to every single student because you're going to waste paper.
Yeah.
So you can have some at the school, but you don't need.
We don't want to send out, I don't know how many kids there are there.
So I'll contact Tia once I get this packet finalized. I'll contact her and ask.
Yeah, what she'll do is she'll send it on the, it'll be on our, the town website, and then you can ask her to email blast it as well with a link. It'll say link here, like on the rather.
Have Tia do it, you mean?
Yeah.
Like how she does the newsletter? Oh, okay.
Tia does.
But that's a good idea.
At RGS have Lucas send out something in her emails too about it. But she does the email blast for people at school, so.
Oh, yeah, she's going to do that, yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, I can't speak for her, so.
Yeah.
I asked her, she'll put it on the website too, the RGS website.
Yep. You did ask her or you?
I did. I sent her a note last week about that.
Yep.
And with her being off, I won't know until this week.
I can find out on Tuesday too if there's a possibility of having it maybe to the PTO site. They were just in the.
Is the PTO site different than?
We just have a Facebook site. We had to set up something quick, so we do have a Facebook site at the moment.
Yeah.
So you sent something already to Kate, so we don't need to.
Yeah.
Double that. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I would like to revisit, and I looked through the minutes to try and figure it out. The field trip fee, did we all agree, go to the top of that second page for the swimming day? Because I know we couldn't find it anywhere. If we voted on the $3 that we were having the kids pay.
I said swimming was included.
That's,
yeah,
see,
that's
so that's yeah. Right. So that's why
I think
was my confusion.
I think we talked about this like way, way back, and then maybe.
That last meeting we did
head.
Too. Swimming's included.
We couldn't find it on the last meeting.
Okay.
Because one of us is really passionate about swimming.
Yeah, that would be me. So my understanding is, I can clarify the minutes too, is that the field trip fees are just for Tuesday. And that the
yes.
Fees do not include the Friday swim trip.
True. So that needs to be like in big highlighted gold as our advertisement.
One free trip.
Some kids, this might be their only opportunity to swim.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Okay. So that was my question.
And that on Tuesday they need to bring money for lunch or bring a lunch. Is that correct?
Yes.
If
although that would also depend on what part of the night actually. Okay. This one?
You know, that conversation about fees for trips because you're working on your package.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
All
right, so anybody looking through, anybody else have any questions about page 2?
No.
Website. I think that was my only. And then I like Dee's lovely, look at advertisement. That's lovely. Yes, good.
What are the lawn games?
We don't know.
Lawn darts.
Well, that's what I first came to mind when I saw lawn games.
That's safe.
I wrote volleyball, softball.
Plastic shoes.
Okay.
Just putting on my English teacher hat here, and campers needs an apostrophe.
What was that?
Campers needs an apostrophe.
Oh, okay. That's
it.
Is that a red pen you have right there?
It's the lost art apostrophe.
I'm posting on Facebook. You already corrected my editing. Oh my god, that's
okay.
That's Dan. We found your new responsibility.
Proofreader.
Okay,
perfect.
So we're good with.
He found it. I found a couple more.
Just the apostrophes are tricky sometimes.
All right, so I need to make sure to go through and get the apostrophe in.
Okay. All right. Anything looking? That looks lovely on that page. Okay, so let's go to the third page, which is all right. So I have a pet peeve.
just because I have 5 kids. So we,
you want more lines?
I need more lines for children.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Well, I'll see if I can put it in there. See what I did last year?
Oh, okay, yeah. Oh, I already scrolled down past that.
Write them back, add your lines.
Yeah.
Add more lines.
Yeah, just a couple. And actually, you might have more room, because I was kind of looking at this. Do we need that? So I kind of, you know, if you want to see my little squiggly on the bottom, so I was kind of, you know, this is kind of partial payment stuff along the bottom, and I'm like, we're not really doing that, right?
Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll take that.
So I think we should just remove that, and then, so my other question, and I flip-flop, so all of you will be very helpful on this. On the weekly, so pre and post care, right? Pre-camp, post-camp.
Mm-hmm.
D has that out by week that they may pick and choose. Do we want to do that? You're a big fan of the whole pre and post care.
So I'll tell you actually why I did that, so that we would know.
I'm looking at you. You're the working mom. You need to drop off.
I drop them off as long as I can.
Yeah. but you understand what I'm saying? So if we have a family though that goes through here and says, oh, I want camp, I want for week 1, 4, 7, and 8 for pre-camp, and I want post-camp for week 2, 5, 7, I mean, I don't know.
And then you fluctuate between 16 camper maximum.
Right.
So in my mind, I was doing it just, if we only have 8 kids signed up for post-care, then that's only one council we're paying for in the morning as opposed to two.
Right.
But that's,
well, that's what I'm telling you. I completely flip flops. Like I like it, and then I'm kind of like.
Well,
I
can tell you right now, you're already gonna have 4 automatically.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking.
I think it's gonna be a nightmare just to kind of follow that. And okay, this week we're only one person who paid, who didn't. If we just do, you want pre, you get pre for the 8 weeks. You
know, oh yeah, I don't. I think it's gonna be a package deal. I don't think
Are we gonna tell them to pay that by June?
I want a June 1st. Yes. See? Should we revisit that?
We went 12 and 12 last year. That was your
idea. Well, I think that.
So how are you thinking? You were thinking.
Wait a minute.
You
ever said the first thing.
I had people like hockey, uncontrollable games.
Oh,
wait,
I can't.
We had to pick 12 because it was.
But that's the only reason why. Honestly,
it's
any way you guys
want
to
do it.
Really?
Can you think of
that?
I'm thinking one in terms of money, but also in terms of
everybody
organization,
yeah.
I guess. But
yeah,
there might be that problem anyway.
How some so if I'm using this to keep track of who they are, how much they paid, I want to know that this person right here, they're doing pre-camp. So I'll know to add it down here.
Friday.
If you want to,
right. So how I would have it is I was more thinking along the lines of Lester, because to me,
what?
If I see this, I know hard. that to me, if this gives me an option, then mm-hmm. I'm picking and choosing.
And then I'm thinking I'm only paying for those, because again, I'm the parent that doesn't read it.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking I'm only paying for those weeks, and then it just creates confusion.
Mm-hmm.
So I think just yes.
So I think,
or
no.
Yeah.
Do you need before
or after
pre-care, check box. Do you need aftercare, check box. And maybe there should be something for how many kids, right?
Yes. Something that at least keeps track of how many.
15 per week per child. Right?
Yeah.
So I have 8 weeks. I have 2 kids. So I'm paying.
Times 30.
So 30 times
240.
I'm paying 30 for the morning and 30 in the afternoon.
And tell you again.
Right?
So you're paying 480 for the summer.
Right. Okay. So that's.
And you being a parent dropping your kids off, you're okay with paying that $15
fee? Does that seem reasonable?
to you for your.
Even if you don't bring your kids.
Yeah, because you go with your, with your summer camp fees plus the before and after care, it's still $1,500 less than where I sent them last year. So.
Okay.
So we're, we all.
You're just taking it in a lump sum.
So, and did we decide to cap both of those at 16?
Yes.
Pre and post?
Unless, and maybe, maybe we should put on, there, first come, first served basis.
Yes.
And then have a waitlist, and if we have a waitlist, then,
I have it right here on the first page, camp maximum per week is 16, resident and non-resident combined, register early for pre and post camp. So, or I could, I think you should write first come.
Something about first come, first served.
Okay.
First serve.
And then, you know, if we have a huge need for it, I think we can accommodate, we just need to be prepared for it.
Well, because weren't we figuring the directors, assistant director and director were gonna be the ones?
There would be another, there would be one of them and one counselor, right, correct.
One counselor and one of them, yes.
Say you have like twenty something kids that want pre or post, would you, would we be willing to add another counselor?
Yes.
Because if the numbers are there and they can pay for it.
Absolutely.
I think we should look at it.
Yeah, yeah, I think so too.
May put it up, maybe cap it for now, but say, oh, we have, you know, eight other kids or families that need it, then we should look at it from that numbers perspective.
If we have 17 though, do we just go, you know what, sorry, we capped it at 16?
Yeah.
But if we have 22, then we go, okay, we can pay for another person.
Because then it pays for itself if you're gonna do it that way.
Yeah. So I'll be taking care of the registration forms, so I'll be keeping tabs.
Yeah.
Sure, I should just drop mine off here.
Send it our office mail.
It may be upstairs. Dave, meet me in the parking lot.
All right, do we need a vote on anything?
I want to move in my building.
Did you vote on the drop by?
On you now.
Well, we're talking about maybe putting another counselor in.
What do you?
The pre and post care, if there's enough.
Yeah, but that doesn't have to happen until you get counsel.
I think so.
I'm just asking if we need a vote for anything.
Okay, so we're gonna take that out, we're taking this whole section out, we're doing pre care, post care, yes or no, first come, first served, take that out. Add more lines for kids.
Yeah, we're gonna add two lines.
That almost might be a little bit more, you might add, you know, registration for one child. Yeah, I don't know, to make this a little bit easier, like how many children are you registering for? And then pre and, you know, and then will you be, are you paying for pre care, are you paying for post care?
And it might even be beneficial to include in that section as well, the 16 maximum first come, first serve. Because it'll get lost at the top.
So that, what I changed on the first page will go on to the second page.
My question is, because I do this with my kids, say somebody takes their two kids out for a week because they're going to go on vacation, and then you have two extra spots.
But you prepaid for them because you said that you wanted that spot.
So, does somebody else who is on the wait list get to fill your spot for that week?
And pay?
Yeah.
I don't know.
15 extra bucks is 15 extra bucks.
I think that's going to be an administrative nightmare, though, again. Okay. The Andersons aren't going to be there this week, and then who is, and then next thing you know, we have too many kids there.
So is it just limited to the first 16 that sign up unless we get more?
Yes.
And if they're not there, they're not there?
Yes.
I think that's something we could visit maybe next year once we get.
Once we figure this out.
I just figured I'd ask.
Yeah, no, good question.
And then we're going to eliminate this whole bottom section of this page.
Yeah, pretty much there's going to be like, how many kids are you registering or
something
like that.
So I'm going to change all this. Total will be on May 12th, total will be on June 12th, so you know what you're choosing.
Yeah.
Adding how many kids, or how many pre and post care. I'm going to take all that out.
Okay.
Looks good.
Did you have two, okay, I just wanted to make sure it was a list.
I don't know if I, something didn't print right. Maybe it just.
Yeah, that's a different, right?
Photo release off the
station. So that's, I missed that whole
thing. That's the next page.
Apparently my printer didn't print that.
The next page is the registration.
Oh, that I definitely missed.
So this I've already taken out.
Wow, sorry, everybody, I didn't come up on my stuff.
Okay, quick question. Going back to the pre and post care, did we set a due date for the pre and post care? Because I did not catch it. There was a question asked when it was due by.
Do we agree, is it still the same thing? So if you're doing your early bird?
Yes.
Get your pre and post care in by May 12th?
Yes.
Just keep it.
Yes.
Okay, so all payments are due, including post and?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Make sure, I want to make this user friendly.
Yes.
I'll over communicate. Okay, I'm sorry, apparently my printer didn't like this page. All right, so this one right here, it's just the registration form. It's the program name would be Rollins for Recreation.
Okay.
That's another office use. This is your participant information, parent and guardian, medical information.
Okay.
Form release, liability waiver.
Is everybody okay? I'm sorry, mine didn't, you copied mine, Kathy has one.
This is the old one.
Oh, okay.
It's not changed.
Yeah, I don't think we did.
Oh, okay.
So this is where they indicate your shirt size, date of birth, grade, male, female. Just remind.
Yeah.
I do, but that's.
There's room on the back of the page where you could add two more.
Yeah.
And you could just.
I can just put Chad and Drake on one line because they essentially have everything the same, so.
Oh, so now we're cutting corners.
Twins.
Don't you get like writer's grant filling out all the paperwork?
Like change. Oh, look, Dee caught something, that's good, she caught a.
Apostrophe?
Website problem.
Okay, and.
So we're not leaving my phone number.
Nope.
Okay. Okay, so that looks good, shirt size.
Yep.
Oh, is there anything on?
Yeah, the shirt size.
Sorry. Oh, you know what, we didn't put anything in there. Maybe we should ask Celia that question. Should we take a time out and go to t-shirts for a second?
Yeah, we were talking about shirts because this registration form has your child's shirt size. And you know that one shirt is included in the cost of registration, right?
That's going to have to go in that.
On the registration page.
Yep, we have to put that somewhere in that you only get one shirt, so if you're registering more than one kid, you're going to have to buy.
Right, so that is under.
Or is it on there?
It's under payment process, but I did not explain that they have to buy extra shirts. I mean, obviously it says you get one shirt.
And that's interesting that you brought that up because I just got some camp for the works. And so what they do over there, and I don't know if we want to do it or not, because we might be selling t-shirts for $5, right, Celia? So in that case, but like what the works does is $30 registration fee for the first camper and $20 for each additional camper per family. Personally, coming from a large family, I'd rather we didn't do that. But
no, I know we've been back and forth about this. I still think that the $35 per family is an attractive.
Yeah, let's just leave it.
Yeah.
It
and so, then, and if we can sell extra t-shirts for $5, then that's awesome.
Do we know, Celia, if that would be the cost per t-shirt? I can put it in there?
You're better. Why don't you make a well-rounded number? Let's just go 10 then if you're going to go 7.
7.50 and that way 2 shirts is $15. So if you have twins, it's $15.
But I get one for free as it is.
Yeah.
Included.
Seven would cover you for additional shirts. The printing.
Would cover the fee for shirts.
I have a question actually. Are we still requiring them to have a t-shirt, one of our red shirts for the field trips and stuff?
Yes.
Yes, if they don't have a field trip shirt, they have to go home.
Okay.
Or purchase one that day.
Or stay behind.
Or stay behind.
For that reason. So it's only one t-shirt included for registration.
Yeah.
But they are required to have a t-shirt for the field trips and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. That could be interesting. Just throw throwing it out there. I mean, I know the I have a large family too, so I know the extra cost, you know, having to buy the t-shirts and stuff. I mean, I think $5 per t-shirt is reasonable, definitely. Just, is there a way to, like, has it been put out there in the handbook? I don't have a chance to read it. I'm sorry about the t-shirts or anything.
No, because I'm going to present on it in a little while.
Oh, okay.
And
okay.
Give you guys the whole overview.
Okay.
The t-shirts.
Okay. So
wait, $20?
20. It was 20 for a t-shirt?
Last year? I thought it was 10.
I think it was 20.
Or
like gold.
I know we didn't really give them out. It wasn't like,
but. I don't think I ever bought my kids a t-shirt. I don't know how they,
I think
they have one?
You would just.
They didn't force them to wear them last year. That was the problem.
Oh, okay.
They didn't have to wear them?
No.
They were not
checked.
And then we got an email from somebody that said on one of the field trips, only two or three of the kids was wearing their field shirts.
And we're requiring it now.
And hopefully the director will say, if you don't have your field trip, you have to partake in the stay back option or buy one before you get on the bus.
So I know what Barrington does is they have loaner shirts. So they let the kids go with a loaner shirt, but the parent has to pay for that shirt within, I think, 48 hours or 2 days.
Oh, that's not bad.
That's actually not a bad idea.
Oh,
that's true.
Sometimes
it's...
You don't have
the money
right there.
Yeah.
Right. Now, my question, does the kid make the decision, or when the parent's dropping them off? Because...
Sure, just put that on my
board. I mean, I can see the energy of having 30 shirts at their house come the end of summer.
Well, one of the things the counselor should be looking for is, okay, we know it's field trip day, do you have your shirt with you? Do you have it on?
So when they bring them and check them in?
Yeah.
It's, hey, Johnny doesn't have a shirt, so he's not coming today,
yeah.
Or...
Yeah,
she's
getting a roll. How many people are going to roll around with a long sleeve t-shirt
now? On your Facebook page the night before would be like, don't forget, summer. Yeah. Field trip tomorrow.
Don't forget your lunch.
We're, like, it was the same grace for me.
They should be bringing lunch every day.
Sure.
Are we getting the parents in mail? That's, it should be on here, right?
Yes. I think that we really need to do that, and I noticed on a bunch of the, like on, I read through Summersworth's department, they do like all their stuff is through email, like if there's a problem with weather, if they, because I know with them, if they have really bad lightning storms or whatever, they potentially move all the kids to like the high school or something like that, so they send out emails to all the...
Am I missing it on here?
So as part of the registration, I was going to create... contact list for parents, like have a contact list, so it's like a last
one down on here.
Yep.
Is that on one of those pages?
Yeah, parent guardian information.
Yeah.
Towards the bottom. Just email, and then I know it's here somewhere else. It's like in the medical.
On this page?
Oh yeah, I see it here.
Yep.
Yep.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Because then they could just every Monday send out a reminder for the trip. Don't forget we're going to blah, blah, blah.
Or like a week coming up, because this is going on.
Yeah.
And actually, we would like to have a weekly kind of schedule.
This is what's coming up this week.
Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be really important to utilize the whole email thing. That somebody needs to be in charge of. Don't forget, this is what's coming up next week, parents. You know, don't
well, that would be the director.
That's your director. Because they're going to have to
consider giving, allowing the director to post to the Facebook page. Would that be really,
because once, I think once you get your camp going, it'll be a closed Facebook page to only your committee and the parents. Let me pull up where my kids went last year. And it's a closed Facebook page to only the people in that camp.
So did we slide on $5 for $7?
We have not.
$7.18?
I wrote 7.
Yes.
So
$7 would cover the cost of a shirt.
I think we'd go with 7.
Then I think
we
need to
that.
Vote on that.
So, like,
how much is that? I agree.
$7 for the whole shirt or stuff?
Oh, that's awesome.
For an initial shirt.
Yep, this one.
Wines and grapes.
Wow.
So I find out where it's going to be down. Because they think that's a waterfall event.
$7.50.
I keep saying $7.50.
Oh, okay. I was thinking we get home one.
Yeah, right.
Let me know when you're ready, Celia, we'll vote.
What are we voting on?
$7.
The shirt, because it's a cost associated.
For any additional t-shirts, you'll need a few.
Are we changing, yeah, we are changing, because we're going to do a competition or whatever, so the design's changing.
No, I think we actually decided to.
Let's just make the t-shirt.
The t-shirt has been made. Did you send that to everybody or no, just to us?
No, I have copies of it though.
Okay.
Same as last year?
Different.
No, it's actually very cute.
It was made by a local graphic designer who volunteered her time to do it.
Oh, cool.
Awesome.
And it seemed like she did it and it was done, so.
And it was done? And are we going with then?
So we're going to vote on that when we get done with this part.
Okay, so we're voting on.
So the cost is spent.
How do we?
Okay, so.
Motion to charge.
A motion to change cost of additional shirt. Motion to change the cost of additional shirts from $5 to $7. And I need a second on that, and I just made the motion.
Second.
Okay. And then somebody, one of you has to call a vote. Yeah.
All in favor of this change?
All in favor of $7 shirts?
Yes.
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any nays?
That's it? Okay. Passed unanimously.
He's getting pretty good at this, actually.
$7 shirts. Sold. Moving on. All right, what's the next page that I may or may not have on my packet?
So the next one is the Rollins for the Rec Department pick up permission slip.
Oh, I got that one. Does everybody have this one?
Yep,
I didn't find any problems with that whatsoever.
Adults, you must have your photo ID.
Do you want to carry this down the lines?
Pictures.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Got it.
I see that. Okay.
No. No. Okay, so we're good with that page?
So, and forgive me, because we spoke about this a while back. Kids signing themselves in and out. We had to, the parents had to sign something to approve that?
Not gonna happen.
That was one of our absolute rules last year.
In order to have this program go ahead, the select board will not approve it if the kids can sign themselves in and out.
Because we are liable.
So.
Liable.
So, well, I'm just thinking, so for the older kids, they still have to have a parent bring them and sign them in. So if a parent does not bring them, are they turned away and said, no, you can't come to camp?
That, yes.
That will have to be an issue that is brought up.
That would be something that we need to make sure is.
You are bringing your child to camp.
Is publicized. Because I think.
And whether you go with, whether I bring my nieces and nephews, my sister-in-law brings my nieces and nephews, a grown-up must drop them off.
Yeah, I think that's something we can address in the parent handbook.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm just thinking how, once that's known, how many campers will lose because mom and dad go to work and the camper.
They can sign up for free or post.
Right, so that's 16.
It's an extra $30 for us a week.
But if we limit it to 16 and we don't get enough interest for more, and then you have like 50 kids that, or 30 kids that they can't their mom and dad are going to work and their parents let them walk to the school, like they're a sixth grader, normally during the school year, they walk back and forth to school, no problem. So they're thinking, oh, I'm gonna let my sixth grader walk back and forth to summer rec, and now we're saying, sorry, you have to go home and spend the day by yourself because we can't accept you because your mom didn't drop you off.
I can see sending them out, but when they show up, it's almost more of a liability to turn them away and have them now walk through town again.
Well, I think we need to make it clear, I mean, it's definitely the policies here, that you have to sign your child in that you have to. I don't know why, I just think it should be our call now. To think about, to be honest.
If we just stay strong about that from the get-go, then people are just going to comply with that.
Do all the other camps around sign in and out,
see,
sign their kids in and out?
Well, the problem with, well, what our issue, I think, is, and I'm just thinking about kids who live, you know, live on Locust Street, for instance, right?
Those kids.
I mean, those kids. I mean, really, you would let your son walk to school.
He walks the eight houses,
right?
You know, and then he walks eight houses home.
Right. So, it's different because really any other camps that I can think of, you can't walk there.
Right.
The works, you have to get your...
Right. Barrington is so far out in the middle of nowhere in Barrington, you got to be dropped off there. Camp Cool in Dover, how many kids are walking there?
Anybody from Royal Oak?
Yeah.
Or anybody from like Hanson Street, which is just down the hill.
So I guess can we speak with the board about they have to be checked out?
By a parent
or
somebody.
Or an adult or someone with a license, but when they're arriving.
I'll write back to the board if you guys don't choose.
I mean, there is a liability there. Sorry, Johnny, you gotta leave. But wait a minute, why do we need a parent there to check them in if they're already registered? To get them there? Well, they're already there.
I like your point.
I think we
have a very interesting, you know, location.
The liability of them sending them away definitely has my interest of like, not letting them.
I mean, it happened? Yeah. Plus, they just get out of there.
Jody, you'll ask the board about that?
Sure.
Okay. Okay, so
is that a vote? Hmm? Is that a vote?
That
we have to vote on that.
Do you want us to vote that we accept it? Or
no, you have to, as a committee, I have to bring back to the board that information. Are you all in unanimous?
Okay.
Make a motion.
You don't need a motion. Okay. So Lester says
you have to do stuff as a board.
Right, right. Mm-hmm. I am, and actually I'm kind of sitting here thinking, how do we want to word it? Because, you know, I could see for your son, like for a sixth grader, right? I mean, you let him walk to school and back home from school, so... What do we want to say to the board? Do we want to have...
any 6th, 7th, and 8th graders?
Should that be an age thing then? Should it be an age thing that they can...
But they still can't check themselves out.
So you're saying that
everybody
that's...
Everybody has to be checked.
Okay, so let's... So we're all on board with that. Everybody has to be checked out.
Does that need to be one of them?
Just to be checked
out? That's the way it is now.
Okay, so what we're putting forward to the board is we would like the board to make a decision on if kids can check themselves in without an adult.
Is there an age limit on that?
No, because I mean, if it's an even younger kid, then it's even more liability sending them back.
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
But
yeah, Kath.
If a sixth grader can walk their first grade brother or sister to school, that would be okay.
Right.
So we don't want this to be preventing people from getting in, you know, all from camp,
right.
Too, yeah.
Okay, so then no age limit, right? So we're saying that we would like it to be possible to have kids check themselves in the morning. Is that are we in favor of, yes?
Unless they have a medical issue, like if they have to bring like certain medical things with them for the day, then the parent should have to sign it.
Like an EpiPen or something.
Or if they're diabetic.
Because they will need to make sure they have the proper medication with them. I have a child who's diabetic and she never has the medication, so.
My thought is, as a parent, though, wouldn't you be dropping it off, though, right?
I am a diabetic, that's why I'm giggling right now.
So you know.
Legally, the best way to go is probably we need to have the parents there when they're checking. I just have to guess legally, that's the way to go. But to cover everybody's bags, I guess, but I totally understand.
My son has ADHD and I can't make sure he can make it to the car from here.
Yeah.
So.
Well, why don't we just ask, so the board to consider letting grades 6 through 8 check themselves in, but under zero circumstances, check yourself out.
But again, the eighth grader bringing their second grade
brother
or sister, or sixth grader, which they always walk to school and bring him to school every day for the last 9 months.
Then what happens if the eighth grader says, okay, you know, see, okay, I'm leaving for work, all right, I'm going to bring myself to some work and then never show up. Do we then have to call the parent to say, where is Billy? He didn't make it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's, yeah.
So.
Which is what happened last. So why don't we just, we'll just leave it as is?
I think we're going to lose.
There's too many variables, I think. Unfortunately, Rollinsford is a nice place to live. Society has moved on and legalities have moved on and legalities rule now.
So is it against the law to check your child in there?
It is against the law to leave your child home alone at 7.
Under the age of 14, I think it is.
You're allowed to.
So that's why 8, 9, 3.
It's a very short window at 8.
They can be left home alone?
For a very short period.
8 is like third grade.
Second grade.
Second.
So. Very short.
I wouldn't leave that home.
I would. My house would be burnt to the ground.
So turn my back on that.
Whose responsibility is it when he leaves your walkway on the way to the school? Now who is liable?
And you know what? I can actually tell
who
you.
Is?
I don't know. Some wreck.
Who is?
That's just it. You can't put the town at rank. You can't put the town in jeopardy.
Camp Cool, actually, but they only have 53 campers. They have a very strict, like, if you are not coming that day, you are to call and tell them that your kid will not be there. And if you don't show up, they actually do call a contact and say, where's so-and-so today? I mean, but they, you know, they have 53 people. No, oh, I talked to them for a very long time.
We keep it the way it is. If a kid doesn't show up with their parents, they don't show up. Calls, we don't have to get involved in any of that.
True. Yeah.
I just know over at St. Thomas when, you know, there's always people calling around like so-and-so didn't check in and just they got a call home and oh, the teacher forgot to take attendance and so the parents called at work and, you know, going crazy because they don't know where the kid is and the kid is sitting in the study hall. You know what I mean? So it just creates this whole mess.
Well, I get notifications.
Mm-hmm. It's there.
Our boys are in the same class. So
what are we thinking?
This is what I had written based on for the board to consider allowing kids to walk and check themselves in, but continue to must have an adult check them out. But now it looks like the tide's turning back to check in and out.
Yeah, and you know, I'm thinking back a few years ago, and I don't believe this, but. Carload of 14-year-olds drove up themselves, hit the tree in the front where the parking lot is.
Drove a vehicle?
Yeah. And so maybe,
I mean, that would surprise me from the Anderson boys.
No, no, no. And then,
So mine would be in the backseat though with them, so don't worry about it.
From the parking area, and then continued on and went onto the grass of the playground, and Miss Michelle welcomed them graciously.
That's funny.
So again, so.
I think maybe checking in is a good idea.
So, but along those same lines, who's liable if Johnny, the fifth or sixth grader, walks there and we say, no, Johnny, your parent isn't here, you have to leave.
Do we call
and they
them?
Walk home. Are we now liable for them?
Yeah, call parent, come get your kids.
Well, they're walking home?
You might as well start your way here and sign them in. They're already here.
Exactly. Yep. Please come and sign your child in.
So in other words, don't let the child leave unless you can get a hold of the parent.
So now we've
just
checked
them
in.
Don't just say, sorry, your parents
here,
you
have
to leave.
Now, will they?
Make them sit like at the check-in table or something until a parent comes, and it'll be embarrassing. And the parent and the child will do anything.
I'm not scared for that.
Because if you turn away, I think it is, he does have a good point, it would be a...
Which is a good compromise, though. If they arrive, that's fine, but...
Now we're making the phone call.
You gotta sit here until...
Are we accepting the phone call as a...
Check-in?
Check-in. That was my next thing. Are we going to make them physically come down?
Because now I'll just call every day.
Or do you do a warning?
I mean, so now we still have a liability.
I'm so glad you're here. You're like putting us on the joke.
But you put them like as a warning.
It makes me feel like a good mom.
Hey, I'm a good parent, right, Joe? I'm a good parent.
I read the forms and everything.
That's why I have my wife. I just sign whatever she puts in front of me, which is scary.
Do you at least read? You don't read it?
She just says this is a... Usually she covers the rest, too.
Yeah.
Sign right here, so we don't... You're not signing the wrong spot.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, so policy, we don't want you to ask any questions, I think. Is that... Are we taking that all the way from the board now?
I mean, either way, you know, you try to make it as black and white as you can, but there's always going to be some gray area, you know, I mean, there's always going to be some issue. But I think if we keep it the way it is, I think we're protecting ourselves in the town more so than if we open it up.
But I do like the adding, if the child gets there, the child's staying there.
Stay there, yeah.
And
until,
you will have to come in and sign him in.
And if a parent like me says, oh, kid's there already, I'll wait till 4 o'clock to come sign him in. Well, okay, then Johnny sits there for 9 hours and is really unhappy when he gets home with mom and dad.
It won't happen again.
So that, you know what, that information needs to be relayed under the parent handbook.
It is.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's all in here.
All right.
1.20.
All right.
So if I get this correct, if the child shows up alone, a call to the parents will be made. Well, the child sits at the check-in desk until the parent signs them in, all day if necessary.
Yep. And it can be a parent or anyone on the list to sign in, sign out.
Yeah. That's true, too. They can send a grandparent over there at work. That's a good point.
Lester, you have a grandparent backup, right?
I have 8 houses and I work from home.
Oh,
so
you
I can't get there.
What should we put the counselor on?
Where are we?
And what I will do is I will put her as one of my people, because she's over 18, and then she can send them in. And out. Oh, I just figured this out.
Wow.
Assuming she gets rehired, of course.
So now we're on the camp consent form.
Do you consent that your child can be photographed, they can see G movies, G and PG movies, and off-site walks, participate in off-site walks if we have any.
So the library, the community garden are all within a mile, right? Mm-hmm. Okay.
I even think Scoutland is within a mile as well.
What is?
The Scoutlands.
The Scoutlands.
Maybe getting to the Scoutlands.
It's over the
overpass.
Yes. Okay. Headed towards Haley's house.
All right, so that looks good.
Yeah. Next is behavioral management policy. Does everybody okay? That one, behavioral management policy.
Did you chase all that stuff? I'm wondering if I wrote in my corner here. We need to agree upon this. This is what this is totally taken from Barrington. This is their policy, so we definitely need to
make sure that we're all on board with this. But I'm almost kind of like, should we include this in the registration form, or should this be part of parent handbook?
I would put in the parent handbook, but I have a question. When you write up in the parents notified, are you asking the parents to sign off on it?
Yep.
Because I have seen that too.
Which one are you looking at, Lynn?
Anything that you notify the parent, are you trying to, are you having them acknowledge it? Like, sign off on it?
With parent signature.
Yeah, it's at the bottom.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, parent signature.
But if they're written up, do they have to sign it?
Oh.
Or is the telephone call acknowledging that they were stealing fine enough? Like, you written up and parents were notified.
I think that can be followed up with an email, and now you have it documented.
But then, does the parent sign it, recognizing that they read it and not the child? Because at my house, I leave my email open, and my kids can go on and check my email.
You're gonna stop doing that.
You're right, I do. But I have a 5-year-old and a 2-year-old that haven't figured out how to use the email yet.
So the behavioral management is on the last page of the parent handbook, too. So we
I think we should just take this out of the registration form. I don't think we need it for registration.
Soon.
Yeah.
But, and what you're saying, they got to sign their child out. So here, you're signing Johnny out.
Yeah.
He was dropping F-bombs all day.
Yeah.
Here you go. Sign
yes.
this. Or whatever.
Absolutely. All right. And then the next page, I think, is medical.
Medical treatment and medical authorization form. I don't have any questions about this. This is another thing we stole from Barrington, so.
Yeah, I just basically just, you know, the name of the child and what kind of type of medication they have. Information. Yeah, it's pretty popular. Does anybody have any questions on that?
So are you going to allow them to give them Tums or anything? Because I know what the schools.
The schools use cough drops and Tums as placebos. And like at Garrison, they had these cough drops. And if you came in for a tummy ache, a headache, a broken arm, a broken leg,
they gave you a
cough drop. And they would lie on the couch and feel better and go back to class. Same thing with the Tums, and it works great.
Well, we can give them Tic Tacs and just not tell them what they are. There you go. They look like pills.
Right, exactly. So it's really cute.
Yeah.
And then Stratford School uses the ice pack Boo Boo Bears. You know, they reuse Boo Boo Bears. So, but same thing. Bellyache, tummy ache. You know, whatever it is. I'll put a boo-boo on it, you're fine.
So is that considered basic first aid when you're giving like a Tums or aspirin?
You mean?
Are we keeping first aid?
Well, for the school,
yes.
You have to have permission for basic first aid, like stuff like that. So is that kind of
interesting? I had a question.
That's, yeah, I didn't see that in here.
Yeah,
that, yeah, you were allowed to
have
first
aid.
Is it in here?
I didn't see it.
Yeah, like you're allowed to give my kid. Like ibuprofen and
something
like that.
So they
had
it
there.
Just the medication
that
they're supposed to have.
And you can say no.
Yes.
Because it's summertime. A freeze pop works the same way.
Amazon. The first aid favorites.
Unless the school gets a discount form.
Okay. So.
Or maybe donate it.
Because they're signing off basically on basic first aid.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But
there's
basic first aid considered.
Good. Okay. Do we ask for their insurance and stuff like that too?
Yep. It's on there.
It's on
okay,
the
perfect.
Registration form.
Yep.
Does it say like choice of hospital?
And that's covered. That's covered in policies too in the first aid. 1.27.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's
so
a registration
handbook.
So it's not in this one that their insurance and stuff is provided, or is it?
It is. It's on the last page. No, wait. Second to the last page.
No.
No, it was on
the second to the last
healthcare
page.
Healthcare prescriber.
Right.
second to the last comment is medical information. If you go to the PAM handbook, it just tells you that they'll be administered first aid if necessary, but was considered basic first aid.
I don't think that they, I'm just trying to think about it, almost for grade school. I don't believe they give that stuff out. They do not give you Tylenol or ibuprofen without.
Well, ibuprofen would be a no-no. You would have to sign up on something.
So I had to sign it for a middle school and high school, and I know that we have, you know, 6 or 8 going in there too. So I don't think, I mean, elementary school, obviously, I don't think it's appropriate to sign off on that or need to sign off on that, but for like middle school, you know, up to 8.
What did they do last year? Did they have?
Not much.
Any?
I listed allergies.
My question, other question is, what about kids who have inhalers? Say they forget their inhaler at home. I know the school nurse now has an extra inhaler or two in her office for.
No, I think it's just for one child.
Yeah, no, like, Shelby had asthma for a while, so we actually, Shelby had to have one on her and then one left at the nurse's office. But I don't know.
So you would provide like a glucagon pen then?
Yes, I actually provide everything for the school for the diabetes. Like, she has a full kit at school. My other daughter's asthmatic and she has a full asthma regimen at school. So if, because I know the school has a liability for that too, so like if something happens, they're liable. So I didn't know if, so I'm just remembering registration for the middle schooler and the high schooler having to sign off to give the nurse permission to give her or administer ibuprofen, Tylenol, or any of the over-the-counter necessary.
Right. But we're also approving a nurse to do it versus
a director.
Versus a director or somebody who's qualified.
So, I mean, my thought is, you know what?
What are you going to do with testing?
But that's part of the registration.
Now you're dealing with
fingerprinting.
Kids usually do.
Are we going to?
Yeah, that's
she
what
tests herself.
Yeah. Most kids test themselves. You for second, third graders, I've seen at the nurse's station, they test themselves.
I worry about this, but I see under the, each medication should be kept in the child's possession. My concern is what if somebody else gets into their backpack?
Yeah, that's another good point.
I remember from being in college, we used to swap meds. If we wanted to pull it all later, you'd give me some of your Ritalin. I'll
split it all up.
If you guys look on this, on the medical treatment and medical...
This part we didn't.
I don't know. Part of authorization form, that there's each medication to be taken will remain in the child's possession to be placed in the same location in the child's backpack each day. Camp staff are not authorized to administer medication. They will remind and supervise the taking of medication or participant and medication list below.
And here's something else. Yeah. So if you go to the PAM handbook for Barrington, the way they have medication laid out is, guidelines are as follows. All medications shall be in a secure container labeled with child's name, the name of the medication, the dosage amount, the time or times to be given. All medication must be given to the assistant director or recreation director. All medication will be kept in the recreation office. We must have a medical authorization form or file.
But that contradicts what you have in the registration packet.
It does.
What section is
she
in?
Well, we stole this. Yeah, we stole this from Barrington, didn't we? I'm going to have to tell her. I can't call her. I certainly like, honestly, I like that better, that if there's somebody who needs to take
a medication. They can have a separate office
or a room. So that was one of my questions. Can they, can the school spare a sort of office? Like for the director or anything like that, for cases like that?
Well, didn't they use the
Teacher's lounge? It's usually where
you Well, if they use the teacher's lounge, then you have a fridge for insulin or whatever.
But now what happens when they go on a trip? And now they have to remember, okay, Sally's med, okay, I need to get that, and then what happens if you forget Sally's?
This could be one of the responsibilities of the director, assistant director.
I used to work in a school with all special needs kids,
and we had a cooler that was just, that had medications on it, and
it would be the responsibility of the director to make sure that if they had the teacher's room, they had ice packs in there, and that, or a bag of ice, they take it out of the freezer on the morning of the field trip, put it in the cooler with the medications that need to be kept cold, and the other medications, everything, all the medications go in that one cooler, and then the either the assistant director or the director, whoever's going, and would take that with them on their field trip. And the kids that are staying back would get their medications from the other person, the assistant director or director, whoever stayed back.
So we're saying that no matter what on a field trip day, the assistant director, the director is going in, what the chosen person staying back? Is that what we're saying?
I thought that's what we had already decided.
We decided that last meeting.
Yeah.
Blake wasn't here.
Sorry.
I'm sorry. I missed it when I read the notes in.
So do you want to take this out and replace it with this?
Yes, I think so. So is everybody, so with this, we remove this information.
What are we on?
And replace it. So this, because it is contradicting, we're going to remove this part about the medication, and Dee's going to take it from the parent handbook.
It says that all the medication goes to the director or assistant director.
I think that's a better plan.
But we're keeping bullet point two, campers are not, camp staff is not authorized to administer blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
Is this whole medical treatment, is this going in the parent handbook, not in the registration, or?
If you can remove this set right here, where it says all of this, and then replace it with what is in.
Oh, I see.
No, we're only including this.
But keep it in.
So are we removing the whole section, or are we just removing bullet point one?
I think we're moving everything except for bullet point two.
Okay.
Okay, so.
Keeping bullet point two and taking everything else out.
So keep two, and we're going to add 1.12.1.
There's no reason to delete bullet point three, though.
Well, only it's redundant.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Okay.
No, wait.
I mean.
It says medical personnel are not.
So the camp staff are not authorized.
Yes.
And you're going to fix the section where it says that they'll keep it in the room?
Yep.
Yeah,
that the be in charge.
Swap it out.
So next page, and I don't know, maybe it's the last page. Yeah.
Oh, the sport house one, maybe?
Yeah, do we even need to put that in there?
I don't know. I know last time we talked, we thought it was a good idea, but we don't have to, because then it's almost like begging to have to do some more administrative work.
So Barrington created this. You think we need to leave it out?
Yeah, Barrington created that because they apparently had some issues.
I would leave it out, but
yeah.
Have a copy or two on hand
in case somebody asks.
Yes.
Maybe we have a couple families that's going on. So,
yep.
Okay, so we'll move that. All right, so we feel good? Awesome.
Okay, so I'll get this all updated. I don't think we need to look at it again. So I'll get it updated. Get Tia to post it. You can put a link on Facebook.
Will you be sending it out to all of us?
Yes.
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 So I'm just
absolutely. So you can fill it out and return it back to me, right? And I'll make sure Rollinsburg Grade School has copies.
Then I check the
town hall. What?
You check.
Drop that
off.
Then I check the email.
Okay, let's go back.
I'm good.
Did everybody have a chance to read the minutes from the last meeting? I did, out of necessity. All in favor of approving minutes from our last, when was that, 129?
Yeah.
Right?
So,
No, it was the 20.
No, it was 212.
Oh, okay, 212. Sorry.
I.
If all approve?
Yes, second.
And in favor. Okay, so Kelly made the motion, Jody seconded, and then we need a everybody say aye.
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 Before you go to shirts, can I, I got finally a packet of information that I really just handed over to Jody because from the University of New Hampshire, it's federal work study information, and I'm kind of just like throwing that her way. There's paperwork and tax ID numbers and things like that that I'm kind of like, so do you feel okay with me sending that your way?
Yeah, that's why my only question is, what is our last date of employment? Because it says they are to be employed September to May or May to August.
August 18th.
So
is our last day of camp.
August 18th. And are you looking for two employees or one? Are you looking for a
two?
As many as you can.
Yeah. Eight.
We'll take what they can.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do we have to pay them?
They get paid half. We only pay
that's
half.
From the work study.
Yes. So it's a good deal for us if we could snag a couple of those.
For director and assistant director.
I like the idea of our director being somebody a little bit older than a college student.
Oh, right.
Unless
right.
It's a, is somebody getting their master's degree or something like that, so that would be,
yeah. And then it said to ask, it says, how do you find?
And then we have to
find the students and their.
We have to post something, so we would have to. Post.
Information on posting work study positions is available at.
We have to do that before we fill out all that paperwork.
And we're getting this to the board.
Yeah, there's like an agenda. They actually kind of laid it. Did you see this in here?
Yeah.
They tell you step by step what you got to do here.
Yeah.
Two copies of that. All right, so then the other thing I did, which I want to, because I think it saves us like $75. is that I went on to the New Hampshire Parks and Recreation website, and to register our buses, we have a choice of 1 day pass, 5 days, or 10. So you kind of got to go with the 10, and it's $225. So we were thinking it was $35 a bus times our 8. So this is actually saving us a few dollars. By getting the 10 passes, and we actually need to, we have to mail in the check to apply for it. So, Jody, if I, you know, if you want me to, would I get that check from Caroline, or is this something that you guys?
Yes, you have to, there's a new form that just started, I want to say a week and a half ago.
Okay.
Where you have to request funds, and then they will write you a check because there has to be almost like a purchase order form.
Okay.
For checks and balances for our account.
Okay.
They recommended a new form. So.
Okay. So I would get one of those from Caroline to do this. Okay. Because I think we should, what we have to do, which was really, I'm glad that I went on. So, according to this, so we get our 10 passes, but arrangements must be made with the appropriate park manager at least 2 weeks prior to visiting the park. This is to ensure that space is available at that park on the desired date. If an organization arrives at a park with no prior arrangements, entrance may be denied. Arrangements can be made prior to seasonal park opening. So, you know, I think if we can get this done and as soon as possible figure out where we want to go and
which parks are you thinking of?
Well, I have a list. So and I actually requested, so this was on the website, which I'm like, oh my god, I can't see anything that's on here. So I asked them to mail me a couple of these. But this piece also is, it gives us the regional phone number and who we contact to reserve and get the approval at that park. So, you know, I would think that we're kind of looking at nothing in the Great North Woods or Franconia Notch area, right? We probably want to keep our campers.
Has anyone in here ever been to the North Woods?
No.
Northwoods, I think it's in Northwood. It's a state park we drive past on four, I think.
Yes, I've been there.
Have you been there before?
Yeah, it's.
Bear Brook.
Bear Brook, yeah, that's been one of these other.
Northwood Meadows is called, Northwood Meadows State Park.
Yeah, I think it's back to Bear Brook, and there's a log path, there's a long path that goes back.
She's done a 10-day pass.
There's a fishing hole, or river, but.
I just passed by this past weekend.
So if we.
My husband's playing there before.
Yes, 10 buses, essentially, 10 bus passes for a certain price, $225.
So we could send 3 buses to one, and then one bus to 7 others.
We potentially could, yeah. If we needed an extra bus somewhere, we would be covered for 2 more buses going.
Which is actually not a bad idea, because we might have that come up, so that's good.
Yeah, like you can go to Wallace Sands.
Yeah, we can go to Wallace Sands, we can go to.
Pawtucket.
I think there's even.
Odeon Point.
Pawtucket.
Rye Harbor, too, there's Hampton Beach, Odeon Point, Rye Harbor, Wallace Sands. And then the things that I think are close are Bear Brook, Clough?
Didn't we say we wanted to stay away from the beaches?
Roxanne was concerned about sending her kids to the ocean.
However, there's a stay behind option. I mean, I know we want to accommodate as many people, so.
How many ocean trips were last year, 1, 2?
One, maybe York, I think they only went to York.
There's a couple of them.
The one to Milton.
Two.
You went to Milton?
What about Lake Wentworth, is that one?
Lake Wentworth on here? As far as the central.
Seems more.
Because Lake Wentworth, they have a playground, they have a beach, they have changing rooms.
On a bus with.
With bathrooms that flush toilets.
Where is that?
Alacoya's on here, they went to, all these, Summers Road, you should see where they all go.
Amazing.
They have 1 or 2 a week.
North Run.
Yeah, Pawtucket, Kingston State Park, Alacoya, White Lake.
Well, remember what I told you about?
White Lake's a little.
The whole bus situation.
Odeon, what? Yeah, you know what, I didn't, I read it and it didn't sink into my head, so do you want to? Okay. But thanks, Wallace Sands, White Lake, Hampton Beach, Kingston, Odeon State Park.
Never mind.
It's a bit of a ride. Easy ride.
So we just, so if I get this done though, if I can get this done as soon as possible, then we just, we're gonna need 2 weeks in advance to make sure that we are accepted. And there aren't too many people going there. Oh, the bus pass.
This is to get in, this isn't for the bus.
This is the bus pass.
For one bus to enter.
So it's a bus, right. But, and actually, here's a little, the bus pass allows admittance for one bus plus one support passenger vehicle.
Oh.
So I could drive my 15-passenger van if you know.
Support passenger, that's a big support passenger vehicle.
So the thing about the buses too is you get a 75-passenger, but if you schedule in advance, you can get a 90-passenger bus.
Oh, is that what you told me?
That was one of the things I told you, yeah, so the other, I'll just.
So basically, we should nail down where we want them to go.
Right.
But isn't that a director's decision too?
Well, maybe we should stop it so we save money.
Director's decision to do what?
Can we fill out?
Yeah.
No.
We can have that set up where, this is where you're headed.
I think.
Their job is just to go and watch.
But.
We'll make it.
I, just a second.
And maybe we find a couple of parks that just seem to work really well.
But if it's only needed 2 weeks in advance, we should have our staff hired by then, so you could sit down with the director and figure them out.
Oh, I definitely think there should be, there's going to be conversations between the director and the committee, for sure.
And then the director, because you don't have to pick your parks now. It says give it 2 weeks advance, no.
But I think it's nice, like, so this is what, and I probably showed you guys, like, this is what, you know, this is what Summers Road hands out, like, you know, week
first
before
day.
Camp starts, or or the first day,
as
I don't
a parent,
know.
I would like to know.
Right,
yeah,
like this is what's happening for the summer. And you know what, Camp Cool does it too, and I can probably find Camp Cool in my pile.
I just think it would be nice to have some sort of schedule together.
Yeah.
And then that way we can line the buses up so we get the 90 person budget.
Yeah.
So.
I'm just saying.
We're shooting to have a schedule made well in advance of the program.
Yes, yes.
Plus, if everyone else is booking these ahead of time, then they may not have them.
Right, and that's what Summersworth told me.
Show off the state park and it's overrun.
Right, well, and I talked to the Summersworth director just this past week when we were over there for basketball, and she, you know, she's like, I like to get this all done, like in March. Like she reserves and.
So I'll tell you guys what I told Kelly the other day. So we can talk about this next meeting, but just think about it in the next couple of weeks. So I called the bus company again because I thought, well, when do we actually get billed for the field trips? How does that work? So what she told me was you take a trip and then they bill you. So in my mind, I'm thinking, well, then that means there might be a couple more field trips in the future for us, because we ask the kids to pay $5 per trip, right?
Right, for transportation.
So if, okay, so let's just say.
Other than the Jenny Thompson pool.
Right.
Yeah, no
so
fee there.
Let's just say we decided on an afternoon we want to go to the fun center, okay? So we get the bus, we schedule, we go. The bus bills us at the end of the month for $147 is going to be our bill for 4 hours for the bus. So now you're asking, at that day, $5 per child. All we need is 29 students to break even to get the money for that bus when we get billed. So anything above that is actually profit to us.
Keep it in a fucking field trip.
The summer rec committee.
But I will point out that when we did our budget, there is no expenditure for the pool. So we did not set aside the $3 a week per child for getting into the pool. So we're going to have to find that money somewhere.
Well, we just charged $7 for t-shirts. We'll make it up there.
We would have it.
Good point. Anyway, so think about that.
We'll cushion it a little bit.
And here, this is so this is what Cam Cool hands out. I mean, they kind of have a. If you guys want to kind of look at, they have an everyday kind of sort of thing that they focus on, and they give you that at the beginning. Okay.
And we decided every Friday's pool day, right?
Yes.
Every Tuesday is park day.
And I did talk to the pool director.
And it doesn't have to be a park, right? We're gonna.
Well, this
like
year
beach.
We're doing the park.
This year we're just
gonna do the parks. Just
parks and pool.
Parks and pool.
So there's nothing else.
Well, that's why I just brought up the. We didn't budget for anything else.
But
that's why I'm bringing up the whole aspect of, well, we're not going to get billed by bus company until the end of the month. So there is a possibility that we can take more field trips to be able to pay for that bus. Okay.
But we also talked about maybe we should hold off this first year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we talked about that too.
Yeah, I kind of think we just
hold off.
And if we have extra money, maybe we can do something fun at the end of the summer.
Right.
Like put on an ice cream social or something like that.
Or barbecue. Lobsters and steamers.
Right.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. The big slide. Jody just showed me. They rented a big, humongous water slide thing for her kids their last day at camp. That looked kind of cool.
Yeah, we can do that.
I looked at some prices for that, too, and it's more reasonable than you think. To get the giant water slides?
Yeah.
Sounds like an absolute. Insurance nightmare.
Well, thank God we have insurance. Yes, we do. We have it.
Remember, years ago,
like a bouncy house.
All right, so.
Yeah. Remember something about that one.
Are you ready for me?
I think so. So we're going to look at.
Okay.
Yes, we approved minutes, we approved restrictions. So shirts.
So this is the design that the designer came up with.
Oh.
Is that a can?
That would be the front of all of the shirts.
Let me see.
Camp Raleigh. It's camp.
Then for the back, we'd have two options. This would be for the staff, either horizontal or vertical.
I kind of like this one just
because it's different.
But can they do it in a different color though? So it's not just a bunch of blue. You know what I mean?
This
it have to be this color.
The suggestion was to do it that color for everybody, so that. The whole camp is
so what color are you putting on the back? Are you going to do like a bold, like bright?
Like a green?
Or you want a brighter color?
Neon?
Neon.
Don't you want them to stick out like a sore thumb now?
The kids are, the kids should be a neon.
Can we get a JPEG of that logo?
Probably.
Because if this is what we're going to start using, then I can start putting it in some of the materials, and that would be fun.
Nice logo.
But we're not sold on these colors. These colors can be any colors, right?
Mm.
To me, you would want a color that sticks out like a sore thumb, especially for kids. But I do like the color in not dogging it.
Looks nice.
I talked to the t-shirt designer, Kristen Polenko. She said if you could go with a neon color, like a bright yellow or green, or neon pink or whatever, but this will be a universal color that the staff and the campers will want to wear, and you're not blending into other camps who have neon colors.
Which is a true way.
Because all camps try and go with the bright neon colors.
But I think the staff, I mean, if you need to find a staff member and all you see is blue, 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 blue.
And the other thing that, so I will talk to...
Yeah, very tall.
In some cases.
I really want to know how many of you like the horizontal versus the vertical, because I had a really hard time with the vertical, so I was curious about everything.
It's different. I'll give it that.
I know, but I was like, oh, I don't know if I like that vertical. I need
horizontal.
Yeah.
I like horizontal, just for visibility.
Sorry, I was like...
Well, and I did...
I like
did
the
email. I did get back to her about going horizontal versus vertical, and she goes, "Well, I was kind of thinking more for the younger crowd, not realizing that you guys were probably going to go with older counselors, and that they may not want the vertical down the back." So she's fine with that. I have these are the adult sizes. What I have two charts here. For what the this would be,
yes.
This is kid sizes, what they would have to sign up for, and this is the adult sizes. She
should look at that for your right.
How many shirts do the staff
have? Yeah. Three. Okay, now I will pass this around, but for she checked in with. We checked in with four different printers to do the shirts. Rocky Coast out of Dover, per adult shirt is $6, per child shirt is $7, plus your inks, colors, fees, and your screen prep, which is 18 times possibly four, at an additional cost. Vista Print is $13 per shirt, for white or gray, and then it jumps to $20 per shirt if you want black. And that's
buy this stuff.
So those are the only things they don't offer any other colors. Blue Dolphin out of Summersworth, who she works with in the past, is $7.95 for an adult shirt, $70.90 for a child shirt, and they have a Blue Dolphin emblem on the sleeve. And then Seacoast Printing, which is in the middle down here in Rollinsford, is going to give it to us for $6.50 a shirt, child or adult, and if we wanted to do an early run, they would do it for $7.50 and have them in time for town meeting to sell.
So do we need to revisit what we're charging for these shirts then?
Yeah, I was...
Yeah.
My $10 sounds pretty good now, doesn't it?
Maybe they were charging $20 then last year, I mean...
Okay. So
if we use the, but then it'd be $6.50 if we do the downtown.
So this is,
and then
yeah,
we
we're only charging $7, we're only making 50 cents on the t-shirt.
But wait, we've got more here. So this is one shirt, this is one quality shirt, and this is another quality shirt that she asked me to bring around and hand out. This is the shirt that she would get from Blue Dolphin Summersworth or the Seacoast Printing down in the mill. So these, and then this is a standard shirt that you would get from like Vista Print or something. So there's a different texture and feel to them. So just so you know that. Now, talking about $7 a shirt, but there's discussion that the staff shirts would just remain like that, staff on the back.
the kids' shirts could say Summer Rec 2017 and have sponsors. And we started looking at sponsors, and that would help offset the cost of the t-shirts. So,
do we have a sponsor?
I vote don't put a date on t-shirts, because...
No, we're gonna have to make them every single year.
We gotta rerun them versus next year. If we have extras, we can just...
Right.
Is there extras?
So this was the comment that I got back from her, was that if we do sponsors, we're not gonna have the same set of sponsors year to year. And that's why you would put a date on it.
If we have extra shirts...
Do you have sponsors lined... Do we, as a group, have sponsors lined up right now?
I'm working on that.
No, not right now.
But I do have a packet...
Billy Hammond wants to sponsor
some. No, we did Marshwood coffee. And we donated time.
I clearly like this brown t-shirt.
Like.
It's so much nicer.
So we did start, Kristen and I did start a sponsor packet, and there's a letter here for a sponsor, a camp hero, and then there's different sponsorship here. And some of these things could be different, but like if somebody wanted to sponsor us for a camp hero, we could put a limit on that. But those would get big things on the back. Sponsor a camper, $80 or whatever amount we wanted. Sponsor a staffer. We talked about maybe jumping it to, we'll keep it 20. And then you could get, that would cover your three shirts for your counselors. If they sponsored a staffer, your sponsor would cover that. And then she put it as join the Raleigh Army, which is a $10 donation to the camp to help sponsor a child. So, I mean, I have all of that, and then, so we've come up with a bunch of stuff, and I've got a list from her of people that she's worked with before on those shirts who donate, and people who are good about donating, and people who are not, in not just Rollinsford, but in the Dover area. And she said, like, the works, and Wentworth Health Partners is really good about donating.
Well, what about the folks in the mill?
Yeah, and we could talk to, and she said C&J is really good about donating, and so we could talk to them. We've talked about a couple of
C&J other would be good because it is Rollinsford.
So.
I knew Moths might be interesting. I wonder if there's Aqua Paradise.
Oh, that's going to be you.
Yeah.
So can we, do different colored shirts if we so chose for staff? And for campers, or does it have to be one?
I don't see why we can't. It may be.
So it was the company in the mill building. They were a flat $650.
Yes.
Regardless of staff being on the back or multiple designs because of sponsors, it didn't matter. It was flat $650.
Yes. And this $650 would cover a design on the front and sponsors on the back of it.
Did you ask them if they wanted to sponsor us?
I have not yet. But they might. And I'm willing to go door to door at the mill and ask people.
Oh yeah, what time are you coming?
Well, hey,
North Country Hard Cider. I give all those massages down there. I will.
Yeah.
I think I will.
The old one?
So, I mean, that would cover the cost of the t-shirts, and then whatever we sell the t-shirts for would be above and beyond. If we do sponsors on the back of the kids' shirts.
I have a question about, because I brought this up with you when you talked about having t-shirts available for our town meeting. Do we want this as, like, I mean, want to sell these t-shirts, or we really just want them for our campers and our
campers.
That's what
for the campers.
I mean, the whole point is when they go on a trip, they're the ones that have them.
Right.
So this
so
was
that's my thing. I would rather not have this as a quote unquote fundraiser, just be for the kids.
So Kristen, a question came up to me by email do we have shirts yet, and can we have them for town meeting to wear, to let people know about us? And so I sent it back to her. She said, currently we do not have any shirts, but if you give me your information tomorrow, as in Monday, the 27th, she could get the shirts through Seacoast Printing here in town, but I told her we were not interested in that this time. She said, though, if we wanted to make shirts like a different color, like, and she sent me some images of what the front design would just be,
mm-hmm.
In gray or white, and then you could sell these to community members to make extra money, and then they're not the same as the kids. So this is what the gray or the white shirt would look like.
I just don't know how many, I mean, did you buy one? I don't know if I buy one.
And so,
sorry, I'm being such a pretty fan. I was like, I don't know, I guess some people might.
No, it's going to be clingy.
If we have 20 made, that's an expense, and then if we don't sell those 20, then that's money that we're...
So my thought was that I told her, we're going to have to split the order into two anyway. It's going to be one order with two parts. The child's shirts with the logos on the back and the staff shirts with the staff on the back.
Right.
So that'll be two sections of our one order. But I was thinking, if we could put these out on our table at town meeting, people could sign up to buy them, pay us in advance, and then we could just order the shirts that they want at town meeting. And
who's
then it's
going to deliver, mail or pick up?
Well, we can arrange that. I mean, I'm a stay-at-home mom. I'll do the deliveries. I'll put my kids in the car.
I just want, tossing it out there, the devil's advocate.
But then people could sign up at town meeting.
I like that idea.
And then we would know
so
exactly.
Only ordering if people want to order.
Yeah, and then we're not ordering a bunch of extra shirts that we don't need. And then they could sign up if they want to buy one, but they're not obligated to buy one.
Right.
And at the events we're at, we can say adults or community members can buy them like this.
I'm okay with that. Okay. Do we need to do that?
Okay. We decide what we want for sure, what color.
Okay, just a second. I got to write this down.
No,
so,
we're gonna have to,
so while she's writing that down, I have a question. Do you guys want me to change the logo from what we have now to this? She'll let us have this, right?
Yes.
No strings attached?
I sent it.
She'll charge us for the logo.
This is all volunteer, and she said she's sorry that the kids were not involved in it, and she was trying to make it work in her schedule to have something over the summer, having the kids and her do a small project, but the summer is the busiest time for her, and she cannot commit to anything.
No,
so do we
want
to
use
this logo?
Yeah.
We will. Looks good.
Yeah, I like it too.
It's cute, it's catchy.
And
yeah,
it's not trademarked or anything, so we can use it.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
So I'll start all this paperwork that I did, I'll just switch it out, and put it on
Facebook.
Yeah, I'll do all that stuff.
Yeah, looks
and
good.
I'm okay with blue.
Can you get this
blue like as soon as possible?
It looks,
yes,
it looks great.
I should have sent it to you.
The whole
business
of wanting to be able to see it, you know.
It, and on top of all of this, she has done a promotional video or a promotional slideshow that has Lego men that go through, that as soon as we approve this, we can put to the Facebook page, and it says, getting ready for Summer Rec 2017 and stuff. So we will have something, and we can have it for town meeting to display on a laptop.
Did you send that to us? You said that.
I did.
Yeah, I did that.
So it's a cool little Lego. The Lego men are wearing these shirts. And,
oh, that's cute.
So,
that's cute.
And she said she would make a poster if we wanted it for town meeting.
Yeah, yeah, we should get one color.
Sure.
Okay. I like the blue.
I like it. Everybody, we want to vote on this? Are you okay with the blue
for campers
design?
Or for everybody?
I think for everybody. Campers and staff.
See, I'm kind of a person that wants a different color for the staff.
What color do you think?
Of course you do.
Bright yellow?
Don't they want to be all
can you do bright yellow?
Our camp,
yeah, they
want to
do the same.
Together.
I'm just
why don't you ask your daughter what color she
wants to wear? Does she love that color? It goes with your eyes.
I'm just saying if there's a camper who is out on the park or whatever and needs to find a staff member, they need to look up, there's gray, boom, found it, instead of blue, 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 where is it?
She wants to add.
That's true.
Could you do like the opposite for like staff members?
Oh.
Green with blue?
Oh, I like that.
So now you're still matching.
Yeah, I like that. All right, Celia, that's a question for your design lady.
So kids blue?
Kids blue.
Yeah, replace the green and the blue.
Yes, I like that.
Maybe kids, maybe the green would stand out a little bit more, maybe the kids would be green.
These for.
Actually, I like that, if we could make the kids green.
Green.
With the blue lettering.
Is that what they?
It's getting pretty advanced.
It was like an nasty green.
Yeah.
Oh, I like it.
All right, so,
I mean, I have gone
All right, so let's just revisit this before, so we want Celia to ask Kristen, we would like these blue for our counselors, is that what we decided? And the green t-shirt with the reverse for our kids.
Yep.
All agree upon that? Sound good?
Aye.
I have a question, are we staying in $7 a t-shirt?
Oh, good question.
I think we can table that for right now until we find out if we can get sponsors.
We also wanted to get the packet out.
But we wanna get the packet out.
Oh.
Unless we're leaving out with the packet.
I say leave it at $7, because that'll cover at least the cost of the t-shirt.
Yeah, at least.
Did we agree on using the t-shirts?
Well, we should, right, because if we have a sponsor, then that's just money in the pocket, right?
Nice to keep it around, it's around for business, the business.
All right.
Yeah, I was doing.
And then is this the back?
Do you want it vertical or do you want horizontal?
I like that one, we like that one.
Should we ask her then?
Okay, somebody's hating him.
So, she did give me a, I'm trying to find the, if we are going to have them for when camp starts, she did give me a packet. Here we go. So she needs the timeline. The last day to get sponsors for the shirts would be the 19th of May. Final tally would be due Saturday the 20th. And then she would submit all the artwork and stuff to the printers by the 21st or the 22nd, and the shirts would be ready by June 12th. And then the summer rec would start June 26th.
What was the first date that you gave us?
All the sponsors and logos need to be ready to go by the 19th
of May, which is perfect timing because we'll have our first round of registration.
But we're not going to have our second, so we'll...
Right,
can
right. We'll just, I mean, I think we just order because we can use them next year, right? So we can have a stock.
So if we...
That would be a good idea if we have sponsors.
But, so no date on the back with your sponsors, is that what you're saying?
Correct.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
And even if we have, I mean, what happens then if our sponsors, so now we have to ask our sponsors for a 5-year minimum.
That's right.
I mean,
can we do that?
If you can use your shirts next year, I'm not worried about a sponsor not sponsoring again.
Yeah, if the following year C&J doesn't sponsor, well.
The same people sponsor over and over and over again.
Yeah. 5-year minimum.
Yeah, by the end of the year of all the extra shirts that my kids are going to lose and everything.
What do you call them?
I apparently hit my
Siri.
Siri was like, what is that you want? All right, our next meeting date, can we write that down?
Oh, wait, that's
going to be... Oh, I'm done. I'm cooked. Okay.
Come on, you got a meeting for at 6?
Oh, that's you, Joey.
So,
no, that's you.
What do I do tomorrow?
I have job postings that I updated the one I did to, because I saw one at the works that I thought was really cool. So I updated the one to make it more visual. And
I have to update the logo now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Although I do like that.
And I put on here, applications must be received by April 15th, 2017, that way we, and I didn't know how you guys.
What day was it?
That all the applications must, and I can change this, I put April 15th for right now, but all applications must be received by April 15th. So that way we have time to do interviews and hire people ahead of time. I also put in here that the program runs June 26th through August 18th, mm-hmm. with official, a few additional training days may be required, and candidates are required to be available for all 8 weeks. I don't know if you guys want me to take that out. And then I have contact information there and where to send the applications.
Should you put in 18 years and only?
I was just about to say that.
Well, the select board made a decision on that.
Yeah,
16 years old with three. You guys had asked me to go back to the select board, and if it's 16 to 18, they have to have three recommendations, and no matter what your staff size, say you have a staff of 20, 11 or more have to be 18 plus. Mm-hmm.
So 50%
at least 51%.
Yeah.
51% have to be over 18.
So if you're 16 and 17, you need
yes.
three recommendations?
Yeah. And your working papers. Don't forget your working papers.
Yeah. And
actually, I had somebody already emailed me today about a 16-year-old kid who was interested in working. So.
Ethan expressed interest.
Yeah.
He was like, oh, God.
Yeah. Is he 16?
Yeah, he works. He works at my dad's store.
So I like that idea. I like that we have age groups. We certainly want more of the college age kids, I think, at this point in time. But, you know, there are some great, you know, 16-year-olds out there. Who...
And are we having everyone reapply because of some concerns with...
Okay.
Yes.
And
I have no idea where their paperwork would have been last year.
And the 16-year-olds, I have to say, we can start them at the 7:50 an hour. What's the minimum wage at 7:50?
7:30, 7:65 or something like that.
I mean,
I pull
16, right? Minimum wage.
Yeah.
What do you think? Well, that's money that you can definitely play with, though.
What?
I think first time.
Eight.
So
wait, was that your second year?
Third.
Every
year
it went up 25 cents. So she started at 7:50.
Yeah.
And then it went up quarter.
See?
Mm.
Yeah, but you would have to do minimum wage.
Which is 7:35, so 7:50.
Oh, I thought you said 7:60 something.
If it's 7:60,
yeah.
Whatever
it is.
Yeah. So I think first, if you're 16, first time hire, I think 7:50 is a pretty good. And then that way we could. You could potentially be paying, you know, if she's coming back, $8.25, which we didn't have on our sliding pay scale here. So,
but we're all hoping that we're signing it, right? We're not accepting anybody else. Well, unless it's.
Well, yeah.
I mean, they can
apply
if they want.
They can apply.
I mean,
right? They got to go through the whole process.
See, like, it's a little questions, concerns. Yeah.
I can, okay, so,
did you look through
we're
going to
pass this along.
Yeah.
Job
postings and job descriptions and
everything.
So that would be $25 minimum wage? So that would be $25 minimum wage?
At a job description?
So 7:50 is pretty good.
Select board?
You would ask me to go through the select board. I haven't yet.
The book was good enough.
Okay, look through all that stuff.
I'm going to email this to the board.
Because if we're asking people to apply, we have to
know
what you
know. This is really bad. I don't know.
Because that's the first thing we should be handing them is what they're actually doing.
So this gives us like 6 weeks. Because there's a deadline of April 15th to get their applications in. So at one of the next couple meetings, we could go over the job descriptions and come up with exactly, and then we could call them in for interviews. Like once it closes April 15th, we can go through the candidates, pick out our top ones, and then Jody and one of you can meet with the candidates. So I figured if we had a deadline that gave us a couple of, like gave us 8 weeks to come up with the
counselors and get them all hired.
Okay.
That way, because I don't want it to them to send in their application June 1st and expect to get a job. And that doesn't give us enough time to get the background checks and fingerprinting done through the police department. And while I was looking at that, I looked at...
I did, I sent it to both of you.
Yeah, it came from Dee.
Did you not send that to say, I'm sorry, I'm having this conversation around you.
I just put that we were hiring for all positions on that instead of listing them out. And I looked at how much it would be to post this job online at a couple different places. To post it on Monster would be $400. $30.
Craigslist.
To post.
Can we just post it on the town website?
Yes, but we need permission from the select board, Facebook, and then local schools and stuff like that too.
I'd say go with those, and then if we're getting close and we don't have any,
enough.
Then we can
look.
And I did look at Seacoast Online too, or SeacoastClassifiedAds.com, and they range between $190 to $215 for 30 to 60 days. And so I figured if we're gonna post something, it might be nice to post something like that, and if we're gonna put it in a newspaper, something like smaller, something like this, because they might.
Well, speaking of newspaper, so the Fosters wants to kind of give. And wants Kelly now to give an interview for free. It's a free advertisement.
Yay.
For us. Awesome. So we'll do that at the grade school this week, but I mean,
we could probably slip that in there, right?
Locations.
Maybe
we should put 16 and over then on there, so because people are used to being able to be younger. And on background checks, you know, do we need to have background checks? Like if we were gonna, like I offered to be a backup person.
If you're offering that, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think we had that conversation because you might want to just ask the police because I've been fingerprinted before, but I don't know how long that's good for. So
I don't know if that counted though, Kelly.
About 2 years, like
a few days since then.
Two years.
So I had a couple of questions. On here I said, please says resume too. Should it be resumes and three letters of recommendation? If we're requiring it for 16 and up?
Yes.
Okay. And...
We need a letter of recommendation or just a name for us to call?
We need a letter of recommendation.
Three of them for 16 and 17.
You just word that as under 18.
Then the other question was, is background checks, do you want me to put something about background checks on here or just leave it off?
Okay. Leave it off, because if they get hired, then they need to go get one. If they don't get hired, they don't need to get one.
So I will make a couple of corrections to this. I will email it to you guys and to the select board within the next 24 hours.
Okay.
And hopefully they can put it on their agenda and review it tomorrow, and then it can go out to the local schools.
And I don't know if you saw it. So this is what did you email that to her?
No, I don't know. I will send.
Okay. So she'll send you a copy of this. Dee went through the Barrington job descriptions, and I just had a couple of questions about our money. That was probably the only thing that I had on there. But these are like for the three jobs. So she's gonna email you that.
Mm-hmm. I just sent it to the select board for their approval for tomorrow night.
Perfect.
And I think the only thing pending was the money.
Email me when you finalize that. I'll definitely post it around.
Hopefully I can get it to the select board by tomorrow.
Okay.
So I can review it and then
to us.
Or
after
this week,
the money.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Following week, I'll definitely post it around.
Right.
Yeah. And I know Roxanne is on vacation now.
So I think
she said she'd take it down to Kittery for me.
That for each one of them, we put a range, right? A money range.
So that's something, if it's money, we need to talk about. Everybody.
So I'm about to turn your pumpkin.
Yeah, you too. Yeah. Okay, so let's decide on our next meeting 2 weeks from today is March 12th. Is that all good with everybody? 7 p.m. March 12th?
No.
No?
What?
have elections that week and town meeting on Saturday.
Okay.
Next.
That means I'm gonna be here 5 days that week.
Yeah, is that a problem?
Well, you're already here, so.
So, okay, so does that mean you would rather not do, what about the 19th?
What about that?
Do next Monday.
Do you wanna go next Sunday?
March 5th.
That would be a week.
I'll be late.
How many of us can?
I will be here, I'll be here the 5th.
Can anybody else be here the 5th next week?
I will be here, I just will be a little late.
And Roxanne might be here.
Possibly.
Yes, yes, we'll have a quorum.
Guys, we're impossible.
We'll be quick, we won't do this, we won't do too much, we'll be quick.
Don't make promises.
I'm opening up the door and walking out.
All right, March 12th.
March 12th.
7:00 PM to 7:15?
Yeah.
We're still doing the 12th?
Yes.
We're setting up the best.
I'm just setting up a pot.
All right.
Guys, can all be with me?
Are we all set to?
We have to say anything.
Yep. Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
It's the only one I get.
That's the one I know how to do well.
So I think.